So is there just one way to apply the AI approach that we've been talking about for the last year, or are there different archetypes? Welcome to AI Insights with John Roese. Today I want to talk about the fact that not all organizations are identical, and because they are different, we have to kind of think about applying the processes and methodologies we've talked about in a way that can work for your company. So the context of this is, look, I'm the chief AI officer, and we are absolutely on this journey and making fantastic progress, and we have learned how to get into production, how to have a material impact on our business. But as I've traveled around the world, I've talked to lots of you, and what I've learned is Dell is a unique company. Every company is unique. There are different cultural attributes, different organizational structures, and so the general process of starting with a business first mentality, find what you're actually going to do and how it's going to impact the business and what processes are going to be affected and then ultimately what technology will be deployed. That process holds for pretty much any company, but the way that you figure out how to execute it will vary based on how your company's culture is set up, its decision-making frameworks are set up. And so more and more as I have these conversations, we all agree, yeah, you should absolutely start with a prioritized set of business-first AI projects, and you should be very disciplined, making sure that the most important things happen first. But then the complexity comes in, because not all companies are the same. There is one pattern, like Dell, where you have a very top-down, founder-led or otherwise, maybe a very strong CEO, a very strong leadership team, and you have decided that this is a company that needs to be very aligned for whatever purpose. If you have that type of company, you're lucky because, quite frankly, it's actually easier to make these hard decisions about prioritizing some things and not doing everything else. That's the decision I had to make. But if you're not in one of those companies, there are archetypes that start to form. And one of the ones that I've had many discussions recently to several of my friends in the industry that are trying to do this job in other companies is, let's say you're the other extreme. You're a corporation that doesn't have a top-down culture. Maybe you're an organization that has multiple business units, and maybe years ago you made a decision to decentralize IT into the business units. That's very common. And so there isn't like one central point of authority for these kind of decisions to create the culture that's necessary for the entire company to operate the way we've been describing. Does that mean that you can't do it? Or does it mean that for that type of archetype, you have to modify the strategy, you have to execute it differently? In that particular example, and I had many conversations and found lots of companies that look exactly like that, what we brainstormed and talked about was we still want to get into production. We still want to be business first. We still want to go after the right processes, but you can't do it at the entire company simultaneously. And so in those dialogues, you know, we kind of had a little brainstorming. I asked a question, well, how many business units do you have? And that particular chief AI officer or CTO in that case said, I have six. And I said, well, do you know the business unit leaders? And he said, absolutely. And then I asked, which one of them is awesome? Meaning is a great partner and would be all in. And that person said, oh, this person, the one in that particular business unit. And then our conclusion was, okay, well, let's focus on her. Let's go make her wildly successful and don't worry about the other five for a while. Let's make sure that her business unit so outperforms every other competitor that every other part of the business wants to do what you just did there. Now that sounds, you know, a bit strange. Shouldn't you help everybody? Well, it turns out trying to boil the ocean is not a path to success in AI. Whether it's choosing 800 projects versus four, or whether it's trying to affect 10 different diverse organizations simultaneously, you will likely fail. So if you don't have an ability to have a homogeneous approach to your company, you may have to carve off the place where you have the best partner and the best opportunity, focus your energy there, work out how to do it for your company, get to results. And it's amazing what happens when one of the business units leans hard into AI, gets the results that other ones are not, the other ones will follow. They will come and ask you how to change and how to be more like that business unit. Now, that particular archetype is the exact opposite of Dell. You know, it's not the top-down culture, but it turns out that the only decision we had to make to begin to execute this strategy in that very different complex structure was to decide, well, we can't do it for everyone simultaneously because there isn't a place to do everything at the same time. So we have to pick our battles. And in this case, making one of your business unit leaders and one of your business units an archetype of the best use of AI in the most effective way is actually a very good investment. And once you've done that, you will have learned how to do it for one business unit, you will have demonstrated value, and everything becomes easier as you move to the next steps and the other business units want to go do this with you. Now, the reason I give you these two extreme examples, Dell on one end, founder-led, top-down, the other side, very diverse, decentralized IT, having to divide and conquer to ultimately make progress, is that there's probably other archetypes. And I've been having discussions with the industry analysts, with lots of people in the industry, trying to figure out, well, if those are two archetypes, are there ones in the middle? Are there companies that aren't maybe that decentralized or aren't that centralized? And are there patterns? And if those archetypes exist, can we figure out a way to apply this methodology to them? So I don't know what all the archetypes are. We're going to learn and we'll share it with you as we learn it. But my ask for all of you is to think about, you know, what is your company structure vis-a-vis the ability to apply this approach to AI to it? And do they follow into a pattern? Is there a way that we can collectively think about a strategy, much like that strategy for that highly decentralized company, that will make it easier for people to emulate and replicate to be able to move faster? And so, you know, drop questions in the comments or get in touch with us. We'd love to kind of figure out what are all the diverse types of companies. I guarantee you it's not an infinite set. There's probably just a handful of these archetypes. I've given you two. Are there ones in the middle? Are there ones that we're not even thinking about? Because in the real world, even if you have a fantastic process that you know works for one company, the real world imposes that when you move to a different company, things have changed, and being able to adapt that process and apply it in other environments and get to the similar outcomes, even though all the conditions are not exactly the same, is a very powerful tool.